Hello dear children, good morning. Today we are going to continue the reading part of the lesson 3, the tug of war. Okay, we have completed till third paragraph of second page of your third chapter, right? And in today's class we are going to continue from here. See, Hippo thought THOUGHT. Hippo thought that Umanla's foolishness, 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 had at last got the better of him. He said nothing, 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 and settled, SETTLED, settled down again in the water. He soon dozed off, DOZED, dozed off. Umanla looked the other end of the rope and crept, CREPT, crept around, 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 to the other side of the hill where old Rhino was sleeping. Picked, PICKED, picked up some fierce little red ants. Fierce, FIERCE, fierce little red ants, from a nearby hole, and quietly, QUIETLY, quietly dropped, DROPPED, dropped them in Rhino's ear. Rhino awoke, 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 with a grunt, 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 and shook, SHOOK, shook his head, trying to scratch, SCRATCH, scratch his ears. Good morning, piped Umanla. Piped, PIPED, piped Umanla. I was just coming here to warn you of the ant's nest. Oh, I see. One has crawled, CRAWLED, crawled into your ear. May I help you remove it? And with a great pretense, PRETENCE, pretense of concern, 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 he pushed the ants in further, FURTHER, further. That was most kind of you, said the unsuspecting Rhino. UNSUSPECTING, unsuspecting Rhino. Your small feet are just right, while mine are far too large for the job. You have no idea what trouble I have with ants. And he grumbled, GRUMBLED, grumbled on like cranky, CRANKY, cranky old people everywhere. Well, replied the cheeky Umanla, my feet may be small, but they are very strong. I challenge, CHALLENGE, I challenge you to a tug of war. I bet I can pull you right over this ant hill and into the river. Old Rhino snorted, SNORTED, snorted with laughter, LAUGHTER, laughter. But at late he too was pestered, PESTERED, pestered into playing Umanla's game. So the hare tied the other end of his rope around Rhino's hind leg, HIND, hind leg. Then he hurried, Hurried, hurried to the top of the hill. He hid in a little hollow, H-O-L-L-O-W, hollow, and called loudly, pull. So children, we will continue the remaining part from the next class. Once go through the today's class, okay? Bye children. Thank you.